What is going on, you guys, and welcome to Top COD Replays. I go by Black Entertainment, and I'll be commentating over this absolutely beastly footage brought to you guys by Skiri. He goes out there and gets a triple nuclear playing a little bit of multi-team using the MP7. So to start things off right there, that is just an insane accomplishment to do, since this is not ground war, spawn trapping, say, 8 players at a time constantly throughout the whole entire time that ground war allows you to play the game, which I believe is around 10 minutes. So to start things off, that is a pretty freaking cool accomplishment, because in multi-team, it is a 3v3v3 competition. What I mean by that, it is you and a couple of your buddies, or just 3 random players, versus 2 other teams of 3, and you guys basically battle it out on these smaller levels, such as Hijacked, Slums, etc., etc., and he is also running the MP7 with extended mags, which is a great, great thing to use, because as you can see, when he gets around a bunch of enemies, when there is a bunch of enemies in his vicinity, he is allowed to be able to take out every single one of them because of the fact that he has more bullets in a clip. See, compared to the PDW, the MP7 probably has a little bit better hipfire accuracy, maybe a little bit more damage up close, but the PDW has this large clip to start you off. The PDW stock has a 50 round magazine, which is just absolutely insane. But here, what Skiri did is he slapped on the extended mags on the MP7, which allows him to have 54 rounds in his magazine, which lets him go out there, go in the enemy spawn, and take out multiple enemies at a single time, which allows him to get these nuclears after nuclear after nuclear, which is just a crazy accomplishment. He ends up going to the game and he gets, like, I believe, 100+ gameplay also. And also, if you're unfamiliar with what a nuclear medal is when you get 30 straight kills using non-lethal score streaks. What I mean by non-lethal score streaks, such as you can see on the screen, he is running a lightning strike, an orbital, and an EMP system. The lightning strike will not count towards his, say, nuclear status. If he has 29 kills in a row and gets a kill, one kill with his lightning strike, yes, that would be his 30 kill streak, but it will only be a 29 gun streak still, because the fact that these lethal kill streaks do not count towards your nuclear medal. It's just 30 straight gun kills. The orbital is kind of like a UAV, just buffed out, so that does not affect it. It is a great thing to use if you're going for nuclears, because you will know where the enemy team is at all times. EMP systems will make their screen all fuzzy and disorient them, and they will kind of be lost, especially if you have an orbital and an EMP system up at the same time. This will allow you to basically go absolutely ham on the enemy team, because they are not really sure what is going on, and you don't even have to run a silencer if you got an EMP up in the air, because the minimap will be completely gone, and the enemy team won't even see your red dot on their little minimap if you are using a non-silencer, which is one of the reasons why many people run a silencer, is because of the fact that they try to stay off the minimap, try to stay out of the eyes of the enemy team. But if an orbital up in the air, which happens throughout this whole entire game because he stacks his kill streaks, he'll get the lightning strike, the orbital, and then the EMP system, and keep running through these kill streaks, or these score streaks, which allow him to have basically a constant orbital and a constant EMP system up in the air, which definitely helps him get out this triple nuclear. I'm not saying that this is an easy thing to accomplish, definitely not. Triple nuclear is a great accomplishment. I mean, even a very, very good player will know that this is just an outstanding gameplay, and especially playing multi-team, it definitely improves his skill in Black Ops 2, which is really cool to see. It's definitely something unique. We're used to seeing, say, 2-minute nuclears, or 3-minute nuclears, or just 1 nuclear, but when he brings out 3 nuclears in a multi-team gameplay, it's a really, really cool thing to see, and Skiri definitely raised the bar for this gameplay. Like I said earlier, he is using the MP7, which I also feel is a great thing, a great accomplishment, which makes his gameplay a bit better, a tad bit better than running the PDW, since we see a lot of PDW nowadays in Black Ops 2, and the reason being is because the PDW is a very, very powerful weapon. The PDW up close, like I said, has that 50 round magazine, which would allow you to take out the enemies, and allow you to also run a different attachment, because he's running that extended mag attachment, but if you were running a PDW, you would have room for another attachment, because there would really be no need to run that extended mag attachment, because of the fact that you already start out with a grip of bullets. So that's a cool thing to see right there, like I said earlier. Also, as you can see here, the score is 44-20. That is about halfway through the game. The game goes up to 75. It is a 75 round gameplay. So as you can see, he takes it easy. They take it easy when going for the hard point. They try not to capture the hard point a lot, because if they stay in the hard point throughout the entire game, this would have probably been about a 5-minute game because of the fact on how bad they were dominating the enemy team, or I should say enemy teams, since it is multi-team. But as you can see, he tries to jump in and out of the hard point, and this is a great thing to do. This is a great strategy because of the fact is if you get it in the hard point right away when it first pops up, you will get 200 points towards your score streak. And if an enemy happens to hop in there and you are out of the hard point and you kill that enemy and hop back in the hard point, you will get another 200 score. So if you keep doing this over and over and play your cards right and be safe and play it really safe, you're going to be racking up score streaks after score streaks. And we all know once you get an orbital up in the air, this is greatness, and it's going to allow you to get these higher gameplays. It's going to help you get your next set of score streaks, and then from there out be able to stack these score streaks. And this was one of the things that really caught my attention in this gameplay. He played the hard point. He played the objectives very, very smartly throughout this entire gameplay, because he will hop in there maybe right before he's a lightning strike, or right before an orbital, or right before an EMP system. He will try to jump in that hard point to get that extra 200 points, which allows him to jump in there, get his score streaks, get his orbital, and continue these nuclear streaks. And like I said, he gets the 3 nuclears by the end of the gameplay, which is a crazy, crazy accomplishment. And the game is rounding up, you guys. The game is almost over. As you can see, the time just expires. They don't go out and they don't get the full 250 points that the hard point is allowed, or I should say the maximum amount of hard point captures that you are allowed to get throughout the entire gameplay. Right there, he gets his last unstoppable medal, and he gets the 3 nuclears. Absolutely insane. So if you guys enjoyed the video, please subscribe to Top COD Replays. If you enjoyed the commentary, be sure to check out my channel. With that being said, you guys, Scary, congratulations. Beast gameplay. Talk to you guys later.